Good day, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Bold CNC Works. My name is Nugent. I'd like to thank everybody that's been supporting me these past couple of weeks and liking and subscribing to my videos. Please continue to do so that I can grow this channel. So today we are going to be engraving a photo onto a mirror. So before we get to that, let's just start a new document. I'm using Ctrl+N. Or if you are on a Mac, Command+N. So it will give you a new document. Let's just back out of this. I just used the minus key on the keyboard. So first things first, let's just get a square of how big our engraving should be. So let's just unlock this because I don't want it to adjust to proportions, if you understand what I mean. So first of all, our mirror is 200 by 250 millimeters. So that's our size. So let's just click the select tool. Let's just drag it down. So that's the maximum area that we can engrave. But just to be on the safe side, we will click on it and we will put an offset of 10 millimeters inwards so that we know even with the frame that it will be, that it won't go behind the frame, the image. So let's just put this on a toolpath. So for this, we are going to be using Image R. So let's head on over to Image R and start this process. See, I'm already logged into Image R. It is img-r.com. So we are going to scroll down and click on upload. I will see some future projects that I'm still going to do, but I'm asked my wife what photo should we do, and she said she loves this one. And as you know, happy wife, happy life. So we select that one, we scroll down, and we'll see there it is, me and my beautiful wife. Let's click on crop. I want to put an oval shape around this, so I'm not going to be clicking on a square crop or even the rounding. That's just, it's just a little bit. As you can see, I want full roundness, but I want to keep it in an oval shape. This looks fine to me. Let's click crop. Okay. That's how it's going to look. So let's just resize this. Not in pixels, move to millimeters. I want it a total, as you know, it is 250 millimeters in length. So I'm only going to do it for 150 millimeters. You see, the aspect ratio, it's going to adjust automatically. If I click off this, the aspect ratio would go out of whack and you would see that maybe I got a little bit thinner or a little bit fatter. But yes, let's just keep the aspect ratio on. All of my photos, especially the ones I do on mirrors, I do on 318 dpi. So let's click OK. Okay, so it should be done. Let's just give it a couple of more seconds. There we go. Now for material, let's go over to Norton. Over to Norton. I know a lot of people, they go with Norton glass method, but for me, I've seen that the Norton White Tile Method works the best. really does, because I have a small diode laser and it literally burns the back of the mirror. It burns it black, as in black, that you can make out that that was supposed to be black, not like the other lasers who completely burn it off, the mirror back. Mine, I think it's the same thing that happens with Norton White Tile Method. It's precisely the same thing, so I do it like that. So let's just scroll down. That's about how it's going to look. We will see. Click download. I'm going to go with PNG. Just close out of this ad. If you want, you can wait until it's done. And always, 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 we click restart so as to clear the image from the servers. Okay, here it is. Just select it and drag it over to Lightburn. So I'm gonna click on it and I'm going to click on that offset we created. I'm gonna click this bullseye. Now with this, it centers it in the middle of everything. Now, because we are going to be engraving this on the back of the mirror, we are going to have to flip it or mirror it horizontally. So let's just go into the settings. Okay, as you know, I like to engrave the outside of whatever I'm engraving, the material. I like engraving it because it just makes the lineup of the work that much easier and that much better. So for me, I'm going to be using a spoil board made of MDF, and 2080% works on MDF fine. Then for our mirror, the mirror is going at 2100%. Now let's just change this to 318. Now, if you don't know where to get your power or speed, those things, I will be up, or I uploaded a video on how to do the speed test. So you can just go to the right hand side and you will see, then you can go and watch that video. Now I did this where I put stucky against pass through on the smooth tile. Now the smooth tile as well as the mirror both prefer stucky instead of pass-through. Now, if you want to see the last video that I made, I will also be linking it right here in the top right-hand corner. So that's my settings, that's my process. So for now, we'll head on over to the laser and we will have this burn and we will see each other after that. So if you feel like I've earned the subscription and the like, please do like and subscribe. See you just now. Bye.
Love the chase and the hunt, and I set the pace when I'm running. I always take what I want and I always give it 100. Don't need a bank, no, I'm funded. Play the game like it's nothing. I'm always thankful for something. Don't take for granted, stay humble. Now wake up, it's time to look at the enemy. Look in the mirror if he is no friend to me. It's not working out, maybe it's the chemistry. It's time to break up so I can make a better me. Better believe in your mind, cause it's everything. You can mold, shape, find almost anything. All it takes
this, I'm immortal. When I feel like this, I'm immortal. When I feel like this, I'm immortal. Don't be scared.
Frame, wiped it down. As you can see, it looks beautifully. It looks really beautifully. That Norton White Tile Method really does it justice, really, because I love this. My wife loves this picture, and I love the way it came out. So please like and subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye bye.